The challenges of keeping feed fresh and safe are pests and the environment. Pests being animals and bugs and et cetera. The environment being things such as temperature, water, air, sunlight. The main one that we usually focus on is water or moisture getting into your feed. It has the largest impact usually on the feed and it going spoiling or going bad. So when a grower is looking to buy a bulk feed tank, and what they should be looking at is essentially the items we covered earlier, protecting from the pests and the environment. So you need a bulk feed tank that is strong, dependable, corrosion resistant. It's going to stand up to the elements, whether that's sunlight, temperature changes, whether that's water, rain, hail, snow. It needs to stand up to all these things and for a very long time. A red flags when you're looking at bulk feed tanks would be more or less when you're looking at the assembly or installation of the tanks, I would say. So things that you need to be mindful of or mistakes people can make when installing, such as when you're lapping two joints together. You want to assemble them such that water is naturally going to flow from the upper to the lower and that there's no edge, similar to like your roof and your shingles. If you do it the other way around, you're going to create that edge where you could have a wear point and water could eventually seep in or get into your feed and cause it to go bad. Other items such as sealing, caulking, you want to make sure that you don't have any spots in your entire tank where water can get in when you do have these joints or laps. The last thing I would also recommend is the orientation of your bolts, whether that's bolt heads and or threads. It does matter on orientation and where you're at on bulk feed tanks on whether the thread should be sticking out or in. And I would recommend referencing what your manufacturer says for installation.